You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Today's podcast is brought to you by OSV Kids, a magazine designed to help children grow in their faith throughout the liturgical year. To find out more, head to osvkids.com. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Monday, May 24th, 2021. Once again, this week, we are going to be looking around our churches, re-understanding, falling in love once again with all the incredible objects around our churches and even some of the things that we do. This is our last week of taking a tour. So if you haven't learned anything yet, then I hope this is the week that you discover something new. So we're going to start this week by talking about something that we don't always see at Mass. We see it more often at big celebrations, perhaps at Easter Masses or on big feast days. But that thing is incense. Maybe you have experienced incense before. Oftentimes you smell it before you see it. But what happens, of course, is that the priest will put a special powder into a container called a thurible. You put it in there, there's a little flame inside, and it will slowly burn this incense, and it will send up a very fragrant smoke. Oftentimes, the priest, the deacon, or a server will come and swing a ball that has the incense burning inside of it, swing it, and bless various things. The priest himself, the altar, the congregation, all of these things will be sort of swung this incense towards it. So why do we do this? Of course, it smells nice. I like the smell of incense. But this is supposed to remind us of something. It's a powerful symbol. As we watch the smoke rise, the incense as it burns will have a smoke, and it goes upward. It drifts upward. Now, that is to remind us of our prayers, that our prayers, that we don't need to just be stuck in our heads or spinning our wheels here, but that we need to be sending our prayers up to God, to give them away, to send them to Him. Also, it's powerful because oftentimes the incense will happen either right at the beginning of Mass or at the beginning of the second part of Mass, which is the liturgy of the Eucharist, when the priest is preparing the altar for the sacrifice. So again, we're supposed to see that smoke rising to heaven and remember, I'm going to lift my mind to God. I'm going to forget whatever I've been worrying about or daydreaming about, and I'm going to let my mind and all of my thoughts drift up to God. So that's why we use incense. So my challenge for you once again is just to recall all of the things that we have been talking about during this series, the altar, the tabernacle, the ciborium, the chalice, all of those things, the stations of the cross, the vigil candles. And just if you have yet to think about or locate one of those things at Holy Mass, to do that. We have a couple more coming your way this week, and I just hope that it's given you fresh eyes to investigate your own church. That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be. Just one more thing. We are in the month of May, the month dedicated to Mary. And May is a special time to rededicate ourselves to the prayer that she gave us, the Holy Rosary. To help you do this, we have discounted all of our rosary materials, including our board book set for kids and our rosary devotional booklet for adults. They will be on sale through the month, so we encourage you to grab these and fall in love once again with the rosary.
This show is a production of the Spoke Street Media Podcast Network. For more great podcasts, visit spokestreet.com.